I'm in my car. I'm driving far. Drive time.
And we're back. Welcome, everyone, to the show. You listen to Drive Time. I'm your host, Vernon Howell. That was a green light. It's Thursday, the sixth day of June, so that's 6-6, 6.6. Always a nice, I remember, oh shit, that was 7 years ago today, when it was 666, June 6th, 2006. That was something. Really not quite 666, it's more like 6606. So, I wonder what people were doing in year six on 6-6. That's the true 666. Don't think they even looked at the date like that, maybe? I don't know how savvy they were with the calendar in the first century. Early first century. What was even going on then? I always wanted to, one idea I've had in my life is to, on a wall of a room, basically create a timeline that is a history of the world. So, it'd be like, but you know, just the basic shit, like what was, you know, the, what do they call it, the brass tacks, the meat and potatoes of, you know, what you need to know. What was going on in the first century? Major plot points. What were people like, you know, what were they, what was civilization, how, you know, what era were we in? Who was killing who was on top, who was, you know, what was going on? How many, what was the population? Just rough stuff, you know. Because if you think about it, you know, we have all, I can't even give you accurate numbers. Like, mankind is, what, 100,000 years old? Like, some variation of, like, early pre-humans is, like, 3 million, goes all the way back, like, Lucy, isn't that, like, she, like, 3 million years old, maybe 2? That's in the millions, I think. But I don't know any of this stuff. It's hard to fathom, and it's not hard to fathom. I can fathom it. You know, I just accept the numbers for whatever they are. My problem is I don't remember the numbers. So it's like, when I say X is this, that old, or this old, it's less that I'm just throwing figures out than I just will say, like, I don't know for sure. And I could be off by millions of years, hundreds of thousands of years with all this stuff. Like, what, dinosaurs were 60 million years ago? So there was, like, 60 million is the number that is popping in my head right now. But that kind of stuff, like, you know, that, like, going back that far, I just need the main plot points. Like, all right, when was Lucy? When was this, when was Neanderthal? When was humans and Neanderthals at the same time? You know, but it's funny. Like, let's just look at the human, let's just say humans will go back 100,000 years. And I think that number is, like, somewhat right. Probably pretty close. I don't know if they were humans or if it was human-like at that point still, or we had already, that was like the first human, actual human, Homo erectus, what are we, what is our Latin thing, Homo erectus, is that right, whatever we are, Homo sapien, Jesus, I couldn't remember, freaking Homo sapien, so we're Homo sapiens, like from that point on, the first Homo sapiens, that's what I want to focus on, because, you know, just in terms of my, you know, so much shit, we look at history and we think like, oh, Hitler, World War II, Hitler. Like, that is so, like, that happened yesterday. If you think about it. We are so far, like, slavery, Civil War, all that stuff. We are so not far removed from that in the scheme of mankind, and forget mankind, just the Earth, that to use, like, science, you know, to judge things against that, it just always, it seems a little foolish. Now, like, the Holocaust is the Holocaust. But, you know, it's not that old. There was the show Syphil and Ollie. They had an episode where it was something like Civil War corpses for sale. It was a Precious Roy skit. It was like they were selling Civil War bodies. And something like that. I'm not getting it quite right. But they remember at one point he screams out loud. He goes, "It wasn't that long ago." And it, you know, I always thought, like, that's when I first thought I was high school and this show was on. And I was like, yeah, it wasn't that long ago. Civil War, man. That's just that's a crazy amount of people died in that war. Just, you know, on our soil, they're right here among us. People died, like, there were battles in New Jersey. Oh yeah. Some fort battles. Or we had forts or something. I think there were some battles, but they were in the, you know, the ones where everyone died were in the south. Antietam. That was good. You know, I get in my car, I never know what is going to come out of my mouth. This free talking is a I think it's a good routine for ideas. Not that I'm going to now go paint my wall with a, you know, a zigzagging timeline of human history. But the fact that I could do that, you know, means that I already have in a sense. And I'm not a history buff. I like, you know, and I just shout on, like, recent American history, like recent stuff, recent history, with a focus on American history. The word, you know, that is still the most appealing, and that goes for anybody, probably in any culture, because that's the most relatable. That's not weird. That's just, I mean, that's completely normal. I think it's hard to want to step outside of, like, you know, that comfort zone for wanting to only, you know, only dig so deep. I wonder if we're missing the forest for the trees on a, you know, a macro scale. And I'm talking about humanity. Because that is the general focus, and that is the, I think, the default setting in this regard for humans. If they want to know about history, they want to focus in on that stuff. They want to focus in on, like, the last 100 years. 150 years, maybe 200. 200, then you're pushing it for a lot of people. A lot of people lose interest. The scope of it, I don't know if it's the scope of it, or I don't think it's a scope problem. I don't think they're not intimidated by the scope of it. I just think it comes down to, it gets less, as further and farther away you get from today, from this moment, it gets less and less relatable. That's the biggest problem. But I think we can do all benefit from trying it.